Hi everyone and welcome back to XCOM 2 Modded Legend. So, let's continue where we left off and keep installing the radio relay, I guess. The supply drop will have to wait. The radio relay is a little bit more important. Oh, Advent Retaliation. I mean, I guess we've not had retaliation in a while. Alright, and we don't have to go very far for this one. I might just bring this exact squad. Seems fine to me. Or I could bring Julius to get free frost bombs. That might be useful for a retaliation mission. Okay, let's bring Julius for this one. Make everything available real quick. And let's have a look. So, mailman for Julius. Yeah, that's fine. And frost bomb. Who had the frost bomb? Vincent did. Frag grenade for you instead. Alright, good enough. Looks like that's it then. I think we're ready. Just checking. Can't really replace the battle scanner with anything better. This is fine. Let's go then. Yep, let's go.
In position for deployment.
Julius should be close to his next promotion. It's a bit of a pain to get experience for anarchists.
The aliens have amassed a huge force to strike one of the resistance outposts nearby, and those people desperately need any help we can provide them. We're going in to eliminate the enemy threat and secure the area.
Well, we're here. And I see a civilian already, that's good.
Attacking the outpost. Eliminate all enemy units and protect those civilians. Advent came in hot and so did we. You won't have a...
Alright, let's send Vincent first, because he's concealed, unlike anyone else. In before this is a faceless. No, it's not a faceless. Okay then, off you go. No groups in range, but we got another civilian. Let's keep moving. Come on. Chop chop. Oh, there's a group on the right. Alright. Berserker and two mutants. We can handle that. Let's have a look. We might be able to hit all three with a grenade. Can we do that?
Here I come.
Let's try. Yeah, we can. That's probably the best move we got with Julius. Yeah, for sure. Let's do it. It won't destroy their cover, but that's okay. They will be on fire. Good enough. We should be able to kill the Berserker. Probably not the mutants, not on this turn at least. But I could throw a flashbang grenade before I'm done with this turn. Let's see, Gordon. We'll take a shot at the Berserker for sure. Nice camera angles. 12 critical, not bad. So, Nick. Nick has hail of bullets. He could hit one of the mutants with it. Not a bad idea, but not yet. We can also punch the Berserker in the face. That's 96%. Or we could use overdrive. Let's just use overdrive, actually. We might be able to kill all three. Unless we get really unlucky. And miss a 96%. I hope not, but it happened in one of the previous missions. There, always satisfying. Especially punching a berserker. So now we could punch him again, because why not? That will actually be a kill. 72%. Yeah, let's just punch him again. Here. Nice. And we got an achievement, awesome. Alright, and we got a promotion for the Spark, that's amazing. Now, can we kill the other mutants? I could gunpoint one of them, it's a little bit risky. Because this will reveal quite a lot of the map, so we might trigger another group. I'd rather not do that.
position.
We can use hail of bullets with Nick, so that's a possibility. That might kill the mutant on the right. Actually, it will, because it's on fire. Even if we do 7 damage, it will then die from the burning damage. Or it will die from hail of bullets. Now, one more mutant. We can kill it, I think. Gordon is too far away, though. We only got Bonnie now. What about that gunpoint? It's so risky. I could gunpoint like this, which won't really change much. Also, I don't like standing in the middle of the fire. That seems like a really poor idea. There's no 100% safe move here. I don't really want to leave that mutant alive. Let's stun it. If we trigger something, then we'll worry about that then. Nope, looks like we're safe. Okay, so that was a good move. We can take a shot with the pistol. And we'll kill him on the next turn. We still got Gordon, but he's too far away to actually do anything. He can move, and that's about it. We saved the civilian! Oh, he died. Superior hair trigger, lock boxes, and delirium core. Nice.
It's not explosive or anything, right?
No, it's not explosive. Unless you want it to be. So, there's the next group with a codex, alright. Are we close enough to trigger it? I think so. Well, Bonnie is definitely close enough. Can we use the high ground? It doesn't look very safe, no. Let's maybe not do that. First, we should grab the civilians. This will not be close enough to the codex. Oh, actually it will be, alright. That's a good thing. Advanced Assault, Heavy Lancer, and Codex. Okay, I think we can handle that. So, Bonnie. Unfortunately, I can't use Gunpoint on the Codex. But I could use a Flashbang Grenade. And that might be a good idea. I think we'll do that. We can Flashbang the Assault and the Codex at the same time. Yeah, I like that plan. Let's do that. It will also do a little bit of damage.
Need a light?
Go, go, go. Also, our cover is on fire. That's probably not a good thing. Maybe I should have moved a little bit. Now, Vincent. We need Vincent here. He might be able to kill the Codex on his own. Let's give it a shot. Double tap first. We got 98% chance to crit, so this should actually be a kill. And it is. Nice. I can still melee the assault, which is not very safe because we might trigger a group. But I can move and then take a shot. This will technically still reveal some tiles on the map, but it's fine. 86%. Nice, he's dead. That leaves us with the third guy. That was a heavy lancer, alright. If I want to guarantee a kill, I could just destroy his cover with a rocket launcher. It might not be a bad idea. I'm considering it, actually. Yeah, let's just do it. Let's do it. We still got one more rocket launcher. And we got grenades. So, sure. We just need 5 more damage. Is anyone close enough? Or was this a waste? That might have been a waste, actually. I assumed I'll have at least one person that's close enough. But apparently, that is not the case. Okay, that is not the case. We don't have anyone who's close enough. So there's no follow-up. Alright, whatever. We did some damage to him. We can still overwatch with Gordon in case he moves towards us. Probably a good plan. Alright, let's overwatch with Gordon from as close as possible. He will have very high chance to hit with the boltcaster. If the Lancer moves towards us, he will die. And another group on the left. Yep, he's moving, so this should be a kill. Yep, that's a kill. Nice one. 12 non-critical damage.
You know that was good.
Yeah, that was good, I agree.
Fire spreading!
You'll be fine. A little bit of fire never killed anyone. So, let's go grab that group on the left. Now, one of these civilians will be a faceless. Two of these civilians will be faceless. So I think it will be best to just ignore them. At least the dudes in the back. They will not get shot. Now, do you want to trigger that group right now? I could conceal and then move towards them a bit. Let's take a look. They should be around here. There they are. We could trigger them right now. If we want to. 100%. 97% chance to crit. I think it's worth taking that shot. Yeah, it's definitely worth taking that shot. There. That's 11 damage. Good enough. Is he down to 2 health? Yes. We could kill him with combat protocol. Let's have a look. Are we close enough to use combat protocol? Probably not. Actually, yeah, we are. Well, let's stay where we are and just use combat protocol. Good enough. And that's a kill for Nick. He can certainly use the experience. I plan to get him promoted quite a bit, because Hail of Bullets is just so good. Now, we got the Gunslinger. Can we kill the Gunslinger? Not without explosives, I don't think so. Julius. Just thinking about my move here.
Let's do this.
I don't think I want to waste that rocket launcher. It might not destroy his cover. Nah. Let's not waste a rocket launcher here. We'll just move a little bit closer. And overwatch. 41% chance to hit. And even if we hit, we will not kill him. Oh yeah, draw fire, we got that. I don't think that's super useful. But okay, let's use it. Oh yeah, Gordon, right, 60%. We might be able to kill him with Gordon. I forgot about Gordon. Come on, bro. Nice, and that's actually a kill.
Did you see that one?
Yes, I saw that one. Overwatch. There should only be one more group with a berserker, alright.
We're losing civilians left and right.
No, we're not. Calm down, it's fine. Shut up. You have a really good gun and you don't want to help us? Like, really?
Whatever you
just
say.
Sit quiet. Unless you want to come and join us. Bradford is kind of an asshole. He has that amazing gun and he doesn't want to share it. What's up with that?
Finally.
Finally what? Well, let's just grab that civilian, I suppose. It might be a faceless, but if it is, we can deal with that. Nope, not a faceless. And now we can kill the last group. This should be the last group. Although, it might not be, actually. We'll find out. Let's use the axe. I want to make sure the berserker will die. Okay, good start. What? We missed a 90%? Come on now, how many high chance to hit shots has Vincent missed so far in this campaign? because he missed quite a few.
Okay, I'll go.
Maybe he should learn how to aim. Well, we can still kill the berserker, I think. Unless we get super unlucky, like in that other retaliation mission with the berserkers. Right, well, we don't have overdrive, unfortunately, but we can take a shot. Not bad. We need 10 more damage. Can we get 10 more damage? Possibly.
Locked and loaded.
We can't get 10 more damage, no. Damn it.
Got it covered.
I could freeze it. Let's just freeze it. We got 3 frost bombs. It's not like we'll use them for anything else, and we're almost done with this mission.
Holding position.
And there's the faceless. Well, we found one faceless. There's going to be one more somewhere. I don't think he's close enough to actually attack anyone. And we got 2 more dudes in the back. Here they are. Heavy and Breaker. That's a shotgun class. He will target a civilian. Yep. Okay. Here comes the faceless. Oh, is it close enough to attack Vincent? It's close enough. Oh well, he will be fine. It's just a flesh wound. Okay, now. Let's check the spark first. Punch the berserker. Shame we don't have overdrive. We could also punch the faceless. Doesn't really matter. Let's punch the faceless. That's going to be 7 damage. Oh, one guy is on Overwatch. Alright. But he missed. So that's 7 damage on the faceless. We should have a hail of bullets. Except I don't have enough ammunition to use it. I could use it on the faceless. Now it's still on cooldown, never mind. But let's shoot the faceless with Nick anyway. Nick needs experience. So there, that's another kill for him. Bonnie. Now, I'm not 100% sure that this is the final group. We could throw a flashbang grenade. That's not a bad idea. Maybe not yet. Let's see what else we can do. Vincent. Where can we go here? There's some full cover on the right. So I could either throw a grenade or I could kill the berserker. It might be worth destroying cover. We also got the rocket launcher, so that's a possibility. Might have to move a little bit closer first. That's the best move for Julius. Unfortunately, we can't reach them both, which is disappointing. We just have to target one of them. There. And his cover is gone. Now, we got Vincent, we got Gordon, but Gordon is all the way in the back. Gordon can shoot the berserker, basically. That's going to be his job. Kill the berserker. There, don't have to worry about that anymore. No, I'm not really impressed. You were shooting a massive target that's completely immobilized and frozen. So no, that was not impressive at all. Not even remotely close. 87%, good enough. And that's a kill. And now we could just flashbang the breaker. That's probably the best we can do. Yeah, flashbang the breaker. That might be the last enemy on the map now. Well, not counting the second faceless, but I don't think there are any more groups. There might be one more group. There's the second faceless. Come on, hurry up. And that's another dead civilian, but that's okay. Here comes the faceless. Can it attack anyone? No. Right? Oh, no, it's close enough to attack Julius. That's slightly unfortunate. But it missed. Oh yeah, no, that was Vincent and he had untouchable, right. Let's kill that breaker. Would be nice to guarantee a kill somehow. How much health does he have? Not enough to kill him with a punch. But we got overdrive. Let's use overdrive. And we'll punch him in the face. Here, have some of that.
Trajectory indicates armor deflection.
And one more. Always satisfying. And that leaves us with the faceless, unless there's one more group. But I'm pretty sure there isn't. So it doesn't really matter who's going to get the kill, I'll try to get a kill for Nick. Okay, come on, Nick. More experience for you. We can move a little bit closer first. And we're done.
Target disabled.
Are we?
Menace 1-5,
yep, we're done.
Confirmed.
That was a pretty good retaliation for us.
The AO is clear.
Are we awesome, Bradford? You forgot to add how awesome we are. Overqualified, Nick. So, let's check the promotions. Only two, but pretty good ones. Intimidate. When targeted by an attack, the enemy has a chance to panic. And Wrecking Ball. While overdrive is active, break through walls and cover when moving. Oh, that's really nice. I like that a lot. Yeah, let's go for that one. And Nick. Highway Protocol. Yep. Alright. And we got the advent lockboxes. Good job. Alerium research is almost done. Let's finish research, then we can check the lockboxes. A scientist. I really want to finish that radio relay. Let's do that, because that will give us the North American bonus. So there's Alerium. And we'll check the lockboxes.
Valuable applications stemming from this technology. I'll have
and there's the lockbox. Shotgun, pistol, medium armor. We have a lot of good armors, so we don't need them anymore. We have two pretty good shotguns, and I don't really need more pistols. We have one nice pistol and the Shadow Keeper. Let's go for the shotgun. Clip size increased by 3. Provides the suppression ability. That's an interesting shotgun, orders, to say the least. Alright. I might even use it. Let's finish that radio relay. So there it is. So that gives us the North America bonus. Now we can go and check Guerrilla Tactics School. Because there are quite a few things that I want in here. Vulture. What else? We don't need integrated warfare yet. Let's see, extra conditioning. That is pretty good, but really expensive. Hunter's Instinct for sure. Yep. That leaves us with 71 supplies. I'm going to need more supplies then. Unless we want vengeance. Nah, not really. Lightning Strike is not bad. That's 63 supplies, sure. And that leaves us with 8. However, we can get a supply drop right now. And we still got supplies in Europe. No, I didn't want to move just yet. But alright. I could make contact with New Brazil already, but that's going to wait. Yeah, we got some supplies. The disabled truck. and I'm pretty sure it's going to expire soon, in 3 days. I guess we should go for that. Or I could ignore it and just grab the supply drop. This will not be a lot of supplies. It might be worth ignoring it. That's 7 days. That's a lot of time. Yeah, let's grab the supply drop and then we can make contact with New Brazil. Because this is still a lot of Avatar project progress. And what's the facility timer anyway? 1 week, yeah, so they will get a new facility in 1 week. Let's get the supply drop. Assault rifle, grenade launcher, pistol.
It is intriguing.
Let's get the grenade launcher. Grenades have 10% more critical hit and 2 more critical hit damage. I don't like that too much, but alright.
I am ready to begin on your order, Commander.
What else? What do we want next? I think it's time to get psionics.
Yep. Work begins immediately, Commander.
And I'm going to make a cut here, continue in the next episode. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.